Hi y'all, it's Jordan. So I just got back from a supernatural convention in Dallas. Okay, I've never gone to a supernatural convention before, and it's one of my favorite shows ever. I actually recently got my anti-possession tattoo that I have been wanting for forever. So here's a picture of that. By the way, that tattoo was probably like the most painful tattoo I've ever gotten. And I have a rib tattoo already, the Oh How the Mighty Fall in Love one on my right side, but this one was like 10 times more painful in my opinion. Probably because it was on my non-dominant side, on my left side, and it was on my ribs. And oh my God, and all that shading, and it just hurt like hell. So I went through hell to get my anti-possession symbol tattoo. Finally. Also, it's super corny because I got it not just because of the show, obviously. I got it for a symbolic reason, like because when you have that tattoo, you're not susceptible to demons possessing you. So, like, it's impossible. A demon cannot possess you if you have that tattoo. So, I got the tattoo as a symbolism, like I won't let my demons come into my body. I won't let my demons come into my head, like anxiety, depression, all that. And of course, it's just, it helps mentally, but it's like, yeah, it helps me actually. I look down at it and I'm like, okay, and it helps me calm down, so it's a good thing. So anyways, I got back from the convention and it was freaking amazing. Unfortunately, I could only go on Saturday, so I didn't get to see Jared or Jensen in real life, but I did get to see Mark Sheppard, who plays Crowley, Mark Pellegrino, who plays Lucifer, and then Misha Collins, my love, who plays Castiel. And I didn't meet anybody but Misha Collins. He's like the main reason why I went. I love Mark Sheppard and I love Mark Pellegrino, and I saw their panels, and they were so funny and so amazing. Mark Sheppard actually made me cry because someone asked him a question about how would you give advice to someone who's dealing with depression? And he gave all this sweet, amazing advice. I don't know if it's on YouTube, but I'm gonna try to find it. Anyways, he's like, okay, raise your hand if you have depression. And a whole bunch of hands went up, including mine. And he said, see, you couldn't do that 20 years ago. He said, I want you to promise me that if you're dealing with disease, with depression, he said that you talk to somebody about it. He said, never keep it to yourself. He said, you can't help how you feel. He said, always talk about your feelings. And I was like, I was literally crying in my seat. I was just like, oh my God, Crowley, King of Hell, is making me cry. And Mark Pellegrino is hot as hell in real life. I didn't think he was cute at all until he went to the convention, and then I was like, yo, okay. And Allison said he smelled like Ed Hardy because she met him, and I was super jelly. And I wanted to meet him, but I didn't have the money, so I didn't. But I did meet Misha Collins, who, oh my God, my favorite character of Supernatural has always been Castiel. It's always been Castiel, and I freaking love Misha Collins. He's like one of my favorite actors, like of all time, ever. And so I was so happy to finally meet him. And okay, so I recently hit my 100-pound weight loss mark. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna wear something that's a little bit revealing for myself. You know, I'm not gonna wear it like to please anybody. It's just like, you know, I was just like, all right, let me just wear some sexy ass lingerie as the top of my outfit. And so I wore this bra. It was actually Allison's, and it's like a bra, and it comes down to like probably 3 or 4 inches down from the boob. So it's not like a bra, it's like a lingerie top. And anyways, here's a picture of me in my outfit that I wore for the photo op. And it's really cute, right? And so I was like, okay, I was like, blah blah blah. So we get called to go into the photo op area for Misha, and I was freaking out. I was like, 'cause we didn't get to see his panel. There was no panel before his photo op. So the first time seeing him in real life ever was the photo op. And it was just like super stressful, and I was like, "Oh my God." Like, and so we like did a little sneak peek when we were waiting in line, and we saw him, and we started like hyperventilating. Like, oh my God, it's Misha. Oh my God, oh my God. And so all this, he was freaking out. Like, I was freaking out so bad. And then when we got up there, Allison got her picture with Misha, and she dressed like a little cat. It was really cute, like a little kitten. And she got him to like pet her hair. It was so cute. And then I was like, okay. And so And then I looked at him as soon as Allison walked away, and I started walking toward him, and he winked at me. I was like, okay. And I'm just walking up, and he just like does like the Cassifer like wink, and I was just like, oh my god. I was like freaking out. I was like internally freaking out. I'm just like, oh my god, Misha. And like, yeah. So anyways, so I walk up to him, and I had brought some devil horns and like a red tie for him to wear like around his neck. And like, I just went up to him, and I had this whole plan. Like, I was like, okay, I was like, I'm gonna pose all sexy. I was like, I'm gonna hold the tie. I was like, it's gonna be awesome. It's gonna be like cool. Because okay, my favorite, I mean, I love Castiel. Castiel is my favorite character. But I just fell in love with the way Misha portrayed Lucifer. Like, Cassifer, like when Lucifer inhabits Cass's vessel in season 11. If that's a spoiler, I'm very sorry. But Misha's acting in that is freaking incredible. And I think Lucifer is, like, hilarious when he's in Cass's body. Anyways, so Cassifer is, like, one of my favorite characters. So I dressed like a little devil. And I went up to him, and I asked him to put on the thing. And I, like, whispered in his ear. He wasn't, like, talking very much because they were, like, rushing it so much. He winked at me. I walked up, and he put on the devil horns. And I said, can you look at me like Lucifer does? I was like, can you look at me like Lucifer? And he, like, nodded his head, and then, like, we did the picture. And I was planning on doing, like, this sexy pose. I was planning on doing all this stuff. But it was so quick. Like, you don't understand. Like, you get less than 5 seconds. And they just like push you and pull you, push you and pull you. And so I was like, okay. And so I just did this like kind of face, and I was like, fuck. And I didn't mean to do that face. And then I got pulled away and all this. And like, I got handed back my horns and all this from Misha. And then I just walked away, and I was just like, oh my God, that happened so fast. I was so worried for how the picture came out. But anyways, here it is. I think it came out really cute, so I'm really pleased. I'm very happy. And so, blah, blah, blah. Everything goes on. Everything goes on. And then later in that evening, we went up for Misha's autographs because we bought those tickets. And so the line was insanely long. And so, because everybody was going to meet Misha. And so there was this huge, huge, huge line that took forever to get through. And we were at the end because we weren't, like, VIP. And so we were standing back there, and I had no idea what I was gonna say to Misha. I was like, I have no idea. I could compliment his acting. I was like, I can do this, I could do this. And I was like, I don't know what to do. And so I just had no clue. And like, Allison went up and she told him, I actually have a video. I recorded the audio, you can barely hear it, so I'm just gonna transcribe it for you. So basically, Allison walks up and she's like, I just wanted to tell you that Gishwish this year was amazing, and I just want you to know that my sister loves you more than she loves me. And Misha goes, well, it's not very good for you. It's very good for me. And like, I have it on video. You can kind of hear.
My sister wanted me to relay the message to you that she loves you.
And then she said, I accept it. And then she walked away, and I walked up to Misha, and I said, I was like shaking because I was actually getting to talk to him this time. And I had put on a shirt on top of my bra, so I wasn't like in my bra still. I was, what was this? I keep saying bra, it's not a bra. Anyway, so I was like, I put on a shirt and I was like casual. And so I walked up to him and I was like, hi, it's nice to meet you. And he goes, it's nice to meet you too. And I said, okay, so I want you to know that you seem like such a kind, sweet, genuine person and father and all that good stuff. And I said, and then Misha says, well, you know it's all a lie. And then he laughs. And then I said, and I just want you to know that I aspire to be half the person that you are. Because he's incredible. And he blushes and he goes, like, just like that, like all like flamboyantly. It was so cute. And then so he handed me back my picture and I started walking away, and then I hear him like shout after me, thank you.
Thank you.
And I have it on camera, so you can hear him saying thank you. He's so cute. So anyways, I had a blast this weekend. Unfortunately, I could not go to Sunday with Jared and Jensen there because number one, I didn't have the money. Number two, I had to work double the next day. So me and Allison, we left for Dallas at 4:30 a.m. on Saturday. We stayed there all day. We started driving back at 9 p.m. that night, got back home at 1:30 a.m. the next day. So we like almost spent 24 hours awake. Had to wake up in the morning, go to work, work a double. Actually ended up not working a double because I got sick halfway through my shift because I was so damn exhausted. So anyways, I blame Misha Collins for me not making crap on Sundays, which is my biggest money-making day. Anyways, I had a blast this weekend. And Misha Collins is amazing, and I'm hoping I get to meet him again one day. Yeah. All right. Thanks for watching, you guys. Misha Collins is amazing. Y'all should totally meet him if you ever get the chance. All right, bye.